Let's take a look at this example here and try and use limit laws to find the limit. So we've got the limit as x goes to 4 of x squared minus 4x over x squared minus 3x minus 4. So this is my function f of x. I'm going to refer to it as f of x throughout this video. Okay, so what do limit laws tell us? Well, the first thing that we could try here is splitting this up into numerator and denominator, because the limit of the quotient is the quotient of the limits. So let's just go ahead and see what happens if we try and do that. Okay, so I've got the limit as x goes to 4 of minus 4x, and the limit as x goes to 4 of x squared minus 3x minus 4. Okay, but let's think ahead a few steps. So if we work through our limit laws and get down the line, eventually we're going to be essentially plugging 4 into the function f of x, right? So let me just see out to the side, what is f of 4? So in other words, if I just plug 4 into this function, what do I get? So I get 16 minus 16 on top, and then on bottom, 16 minus 12 minus 4. So that's 0 over 0, right? So this is not going to work in this case. Now, from the previous video, you learned that when you get a form like this, when we get 0 over 0, when we try to take the limit, that means that we're going to have to do a little bit of extra algebra to solve the problem. Okay, now in this case, whenever you have polynomials in the top and the bottom, often it's the case that you needed to do some factoring. So let's try factoring the top and the bottom. Okay, so I'm backing up a step. So in the top, it looks like I can factor out an x, so I'll try that. X times x minus 4. The bottom, let's just try factoring that into two pieces. So if you work this out, it's x minus 4 times x plus 1. Okay, so actually I see that indeed there is a factor, x minus 4, that cancels out of the top and the bottom. Okay, so actually what this tells me about the graph of this function is that there's a whole at x equals 4. Okay, so now the function isn't defined at x equals 4, but because we're just looking at the limit, this is equivalent to the limit as x goes to 4 of x over x plus 1. Okay, so these functions aren't equivalent, but their limits are. Okay, now we can do what we were trying to do before and separate this into the quotient. Okay, so this is going to be the limit as x goes to 4 of x over the limit as x goes to 4 of x plus 1. And then I can further split up the denominator and write as the limit as x goes to 4 of x plus the limit as x goes to 4 of 1. Okay. Now I know that the limit as x goes to 4 of x is just 4. So 4 on top, and then 4 plus, and the limit as x goes to 4 of 1, that's just a constant, so it just stays 1. And my final answer for this limit is 4/5. Okay, so a quick summary of what we did. We saw that we were going to end up getting 0 over 0 for the limit. That told us we had to do a little bit of extra work. So in this case, we tried factoring. Now we factored the top and bottom, and we saw that there was a factor that canceled out. And so we were able to write the equivalent limit with that factor canceled out. And then from there, to proceed as we normally would, and we got 4/5.